Hi viewers, in this video I am going to give information regarding the subject is the child health nursing. Okay, unit 4, disorders and health problems of a child. Okay, in this we are going to discuss about first communicable disorders. Okay, what are the communicable diseases in the childhood? Okay, the communicable diseases, for example, we are discussed in previous videos, so many diseases, measles, next diphtheria, okay, along with another disease is there, that is the pertussis. It is a one of the communicable disease. Okay, what is meant by communicable disease? Communicable disease nothing but the disease is spreading to the one person to another person easily. Okay, one child to another child. Here, what is the definition of pertussis? Okay, the pertussis is highly contagious infectious disease. Okay, the disease is easily spread. Okay, highly spreading to the one child to another child. Okay, here the respiratory tract caused by the, okay, here what happens means mainly the disease is affected to the only respiratory tract. Okay, so many diseases in the human being body. Okay, so many systems is there, no, nervous system, next respiratory system, digestive system, endocrine system, like that so many systems is there. But here the virus is only enter into the respiratory tract and it will be give some of the problems to the respiratory system. Okay, here the respiratory system is caused by the, what happens, which is a causative organism means, that is the Bordetella pertussis. Okay, causative organism, that is the Bordetella pertussis. It is a one of the causative organism for the pertussis disease. Okay, the pertussis also called as, we are called another name, that is the whooping cough. Okay, pertussis also called as whooping cough also called as pertussis. Hey, here the infection is, how the infection is spreading from the one person to another person. Okay, the virus is enters into the nose. Okay, through the nose, next to throat, lungs. Okay, the virus, that is the Bordetella pertussis, the virus is enters through the nose and throat, after that lungs. Okay, from the first upper respiratory tract, after that lower respiratory tract also infected by this virus. Okay, next another one is the air passage become, what happens here due to the Bordetella pertussis means, here the air passage, okay, for the air passage is there, no, the passage should be narrowing. Here the narrowing of the passage of air. Okay, here what happens due to the plugging by the thick mucous membrane. Okay, here due to the thick mucous membrane, the mucous membrane should be thickened, not thin. The thick mucous membrane should be obstructed, okay, blocked of the airway. Okay, due to that the airway should be obstructed. Okay, this is the one reason. Next one is the, here the pertussis also called as whooping cough. Another name also there, what is that name means, that is the cough of 100 days. Once the children is affected by the pertussis, the cough, one symptom is there, the cough is the 100 days. Okay, minimum 100 days the children is suffering with the pertussis or the whooping cough. Okay, this is regarding pertussis. Next here what is there means, risk factors. Okay, risk factors, what is that risk factors, how the infection, how the disease will be spreading to the one person to another person. It means here the infants, mainly 1 month to 1 year of age group children may be affected this disease. Okay, here what happens means, mainly the risk for the, okay, 6 months of age group children, okay, 6 months of age infants, may be risk for this disease. Next, another one is the kids like 11 to 18 years of age. Okay, 11 years to 18 years of age group children also affected by this pertussis disease. Okay, here another one is that is the risk factor like who are having the low immunity power. Okay, the immunity power should be less means here the low immunity power is there means those children also going to get this pertussis disease. Okay, here next one is that this is the risk factors for the pertussis or the whooping cough. Okay, next one is the epidemiology. Okay, what is mean by epidemiology? Distribution of disease or severity of disease. What are the medications we have to provide it? Or what is the disease concentration? Okay, how much disease severity is there? Okay, that will be identified. What is the causative organism for the pertussis? Okay, here the agent is the which is the causative organism or which is the agent for the pertussis means Bordetella pertussis. Okay, this is the main organism for cause the whooping cough in the children's. Okay, next it is one of the gram negative bacilli. Okay, gram negative bacteria. It is one of the so many bacteria classification is there, no? Gram positive, gram negative. Okay, the Bordetella pertussis is one of the gram negative bacteria. This is the agent for the whooping cough. Okay, next one is the transmission of infection. How the infection is spreading? Okay, here the infection is spreading through the droplets. Droplets, nothing but infected person. Okay, infected person secreted some of the nasal secretions or the throat secretions. Okay, that is the sputum or the sneezing. That will be spreading to the one person to another person. Okay, especially the infected person. Okay, already the children is affected by the pertussis disease. Okay, the children is excreted some of the secretions or the droplets to the external environment. Okay, in the external environment, the Bordetella pertussis is there, that will be easily spreading, move to the another person. Okay, the healthy child also going to get infection, that is the whooping cough. Okay, next here, the disease will be transmitted in the especially late winter season. Okay, late winter season, next to early spring months. Early spring months, it is the major favorable for the this organism. Okay, late winter season and early spring months, this season is favorable for growth of the bacterium. Okay, next one is the incubation period. Okay, incubation period means once the bacteria is enter into the children's health or children's body, after entering the bacteria should be having the some of the incubation period means for growth and development, for releasing some of the eggs. Okay, for that 1 to 14 days. Okay, 1 to 14 days of the incubation period for the Bordetella pertussis. Next here, it can be long as 21 days. Sometimes the bacteria should be incubation period, that is the 21 days. Okay, next one is the infectivity. What is the infectivity means? Here the infection will be once the person is getting means, okay, the children is suffering with this severe cough from the 4th week to up to 6 weeks. Means 4 to 6 months the severity is there in the disease condition. Okay, in that time the children is having the more severity of disease condition. Okay, the disease will be easily spread to the one person to another person. Okay, once again I will repeat it. What is mean by pertussis? Pertussis also called as the whooping cough. Okay, another name also there, that is the cough for 100 days or cough of 100 days. Okay, what is the definition of pertussis? Pertussis is one of the highly spread of contaminated infection. Okay, it will be easily spread, more severity. Here what happens means the disease will be mainly spreading to the respiratory tract. Okay, from the nose, through the nose the virus should be enter into the internal organs of the body. Okay, next here what happens means what is that causative organism? Bordetella pertussis. Okay, next here the air passage should be obstructed due to the mucous membrane should be thickened. Okay, next what happens means the infection will be easily spreading to the 6 months of age group children. Okay, next sometimes 11 years to the 18 years of children also affected by this disease. Okay, next sometimes every children having the more immunity power means they are tolerated. Okay, that Bordetella pertussis, the bacteria, they are not cause any disease or the infection to the children. Okay, in this agent, that is the Bordetella pertussis, next transmission of infection through the droplets. Next incubation period is the 1 to 14 days. Infectivity is the 4 to 6 weeks. Okay, thank you everyone.